So, good evening, everybody. We're running a few minutes later than usual tonight. We are trying a new microphone provided by Rick Smith. He's had good luck with it. We're hoping it'll be a little better sound than the microphone from the phone. So, if for some reason you can't hear us, ping it on the comments and I'll disconnect the microphone. But we did a test drive of it around 5 and it seemed to work just fine. So we are hopeful. And I did not check to see which.
Which what?
I didn't check to see. There's people on. It seems to be running okay. I didn't check to see if it switched to the basement. I checked to make sure the volume was up. Okay. Well, hopefully.
So if the signal drops, let us know. Yeah.
Let's see, it's in here. Well, it looks okay. Okay. Do that. Okay. All right. Okay. Hi, Sarah. Thanks. Hopefully this new microphone works, and if it does, I'm going to order one. Give us a little better sound. The picture looks reasonably square, although somehow I lowered the front of the tripod, but I have the tripod square.
I think it's more angle. We aren't quite centered, but close
enough.
I can move.
That's easy. Would have to go,
it's okay.
I mean, this is where it's going to end up being, so let's see what it looks like. There's that. I think that looks okay.
Okay.
I will return momentarily.
Okay.
Because I was interrupted by a
cricket. The reason that we started a few seconds late was he was getting ready to turn it on and he saw cricket in the basement, so he had to take it outside. They've been coming in a lot the last week. I think we've taken 4 out in the last week. We don't know where they're coming in from. My theory is they make their way into the garage, and then when we come in from the garage, they follow us when we're not paying attention. We have an interesting mix tonight. Some of the songs I had never even heard before. Some were old familiars I practically knew already and didn't know the chords to, but they were really easy to fill in. One of my favorite songs we're doing tonight, I could sing it in my sleep until I start playing, and then it's like, what's the rhythm on that line? So it was had some challenging parts to it, but we've worked it out.
Which one?
One of my favorite songs that we're doing this week.
Oh.
But we think as of 6 o'clock this evening.
We're still making edits on it. It was nice of the artist to kindly do a video of him playing with just a guitar. So that helped a lot.
Like I said, I could sing it in my sleep until we started playing the chords, and then it's like, what's the rhythm on that line?
I think that was my cousin Tracy who just popped on. I just wish the comments would stick for a little bit. That's absolutely crazy. Yeah, returning to a more normal set. We've got a 50s song, a 60s song, 2 70s songs, a 90s, two 90s songs.
Yeah.
Of course, the 90s is now 20 to 30 years ago. So,
are you sure that that's the 60s? So, maybe it was last week there was one that I thought was a 50s song. And it turned out to be a 30s song.
Is often the case. It's interesting as we continue on our journey. So this is show number 32. We have learned a total of 206 unique songs with 10 repeats. And a reminder, next week, my good friend and guitar mentor Keith Lewis will be joining us. We're going to play some songs we've played before, although we haven't played them for 6 months. And he's going to bring his lead guitar and some of his blues stylings. And we've got a fun set and a surprise song that hasn't probably been played out in public since about 1992, so that should be interesting. This week, I am playing my Yamaha Compass. This guitar is my primary band guitar. This is what I play in FinTan, and since Mark Kaiser, who is my luthier, gave it the working over and replaced 8 frets, this guitar gets played a lot. This is my primary guitar, and for those of you who play guitars, I am using, we're not amplified in here, but this has the electronics that came with Yamaha, they were okay, but they never sounded awesome, so I put in an LR Bags M1 system that Mary bought a birthday or a Christmas present, or an anniversary present, I don't remember when you bought it.
I don't remember.
But for anybody, if you ever wondered if a $200 pickup is worth it, it's worth it. I'm going to probably buy another one of these, and you can get the N-pin jack separate for about $15 and set up your guitar so you can transfer one of these around. But this thing sounds great. The difference it makes in the sound of my guitar when I'm plugged in was astonishing.
And I'm playing my trusty Ohana. And for one song, my banjo ukulele will be sitting in.
Yeah, we're going to play a sea shanty. Those of you who know sea shanties might know, but I bet a lot of you might not know it. A little history about that with the band that did it. So we had a lot of fun putting the set together, but it was a lot of arranging this week. We've arranged, normally, sometimes we get lucky and we're done arranging by Monday. This was not that week.
But like some of the words on every song, I try to, like, on the songs I'm not familiar with, listen to them several times and sing along to get used to the melody. And that's when we find a lot of the errors in words. And there was one, every single version online has a different word on this one line. And so we think that maybe it's just the recording that we used, because it was a live, a YouTube that had been a live performance. So maybe the artist sang it differently that one time, but it's like, cross it out, that's not what he's saying.
You don't generally want to try and use live versions of songs, but I tried to buy this song from iTunes, and I bought it, and it said, do you want to download the song? And I said, yes. So I downloaded the song, went to play it, and said, this computer is not authorized to play this song. Would you like to authorize this computer? Well, the computer is authorized, but I said, okay. So I authorized the computer. Your computer is now authorized. Click on the song. You are not authorized to play this song. So I deleted the whole thing, nuked it out of the library, and eventually iTunes will go, hey, you have some music that hasn't been downloaded. Would you like to download it? Yes. Still didn't work. It never worked. So the reason I picked this particular version was the artist was playing. It's basically him in a performance with an acoustic guitar. So you can see how he plays some of these odd chords. I get they're not odd. They're just not super common. And so
some slash chords, so they aren't the basic chords.
Right, right.
The chords with a note added.
So without further ado,
Strawberry Smash.
Peach County. And we shall get to it.
Since the age of 2, down on Copperline. Copperhead, copper beach, copper kettle flitting side by each. Copper coil, copper Georgia peach, down on Copperline. Half a mile down to Morgan Creek, to go back as if I could. All spec house and plywood. Tore up good. Down on Copperline. Doesn't come as a surprise to me. Never touched my memory. I'm lifting up and rising free. Down on Copperline by James Taylor, 1991. Probably my favorite James Taylor song, and I like it more after spending a week working on it. And it was interesting because how he plays some of the chords are not standard, and he does hook his thumb over. So now, in my opinion, if James Taylor hooks his thumb over to get the F sharp on the D, F James Taylor, it's good enough for James Taylor, it's good enough for anybody, so I have no compunction.
And this was the song that had a line that was completely different.
Yeah.
And he's singing, "I'm only living till the end of the week." And every version we looked at said, leaning heavy
on the end of the week. Which I guess makes sense. And maybe I'm only living till the end of the week for them. But James Taylor, he wrote it with another gentleman. And it's a storied song of where he grew up. But it's a great tune. I just think it's brilliantly, brilliantly written. Although, we were wondering how many times he could get moonshine into the song, which might tell you a little something about living in Copperline. Okay.
This song was written the year I was born, so it's a very good song.
And it does not require a capo.
For you.
I'm playing the tough chords. I think a lot of you will definitely recognize this song. Thank you.
was All I Have to Do is Dream, written by Felice and Boudelot Bryant, 1958, but made popular by the Everly Brothers. And Felice and Boudelot Bryant have written a fair number of songs we've played already. They were a big-time husband and wife songwriting team, and they also wrote songs separately. Both Felice and Boudelot wrote songs, and we've done some of their pieces, but... When we first looked at that song, we thought maybe it was a creepy stalker song. Be interested if you care to vote on that. But he's just dreaming, and he's dreaming his life away, so I'm not, I don't know. It could be a creepy stalker song. We've collected a lot of creepy stalker songs.
I explained to him as a woman, it's creepy or not depending on who's dreaming about you.
Ah. Okay, well. You may cast your opinions in the comments. Okay. Now for something
completely different.
I have to have a drink before this. This is in my low range.
Since you're going to do that, I will quickly check to make sure it's still in tune from 15 minutes ago. And it's not.
While she's doing that, I actually heard of the band that did this song from Matt Flannery's dad, probably prior to 82-ish. This band has been around a very long time and written a lot of great songs, performed a lot of great songs.
I believe they formed in 1975, according to the wiki page.
Yeah, so.
This is close enough for banjo.
Well, JJ just joined. Hi, JJ. Not stalkery. from Rick. All right, here we go. One, two, three, four.
You know the sea is rising, and you know that
called The Day of the Clipper. Words and music by Steve Romanoff of the band Schooner Fair. I had never heard of them, and Matt's dad produced a vinyl album. And this song was actually covered by Tommy Makem and Liam Clancy. And in 2008, which is how I heard it. But it's a great tune, and, you know, Clipper ships, up until the advent of steam, held all the records. They were the fastest ships ripping up all over the oceans, and it's a great tune. Schooner Fair, if you like sea shanties and sea music, they've recorded a ton, and they've written a lot of good songs. So if you're looking for something to round out your collection for songs in that vein, might want to check out Schooner Fair. They're on iTunes. Just wanted to double check and make sure. Oh, that E went. Nope. Good enough. Okay. Is, of course, The Wind by Cat Stevens, 1971. Cat Stevens, Yusuf, has been continuing to put out music. He kind of rejoined the modern culture a little bit with his music, and he has a beautiful video of this on his YouTube channel of him. There's some other instrumentation that's been thrown in the backing recording, but he is just sitting there playing the guitar, and you can see how he does it, and it was extremely obvious from that video that he finger picks about 10,000 times better than me.
And this was a song I mentioned earlier that it was one of my favorite songs. It's my favorite song by Cat Stevens. And I could have sung it in my sleep and still would start playing it. And then those lines with the words never, trying to play the rhythm and sing the rhythm at the same time is much trickier than he makes it seem.
Yeah, and I think his finger picking allows for it to syncopate a little, and he's very smooth on it because he's been playing it since 1971. Which would be approximately 49 years less 6 days longer than us. So, but that's also, too, sometimes she tunes in Tamara Nicolai. That's one of her favorite songs by Cat Stevens, too. And, hey, Tamara, we did it. We actually managed to learn it.
And we include the first version we picked had simplified the chords, and we didn't realize it. And I was like, well, he's not playing just a G on that. What's he playing? So we actually played some of the fancier chords.
And having him watch, I mean, he's just sitting there playing the guitar. Being able to watch him play is incredibly helpful. And sometimes we seek out videos of the artists on YouTube just to see how are they playing it.
And what are they actually playing? Because sometimes, you'll get two or three versions that don't quite agree, and it's like, okay, which way is it?
Yeah, and it's not uncommon, even on Ultimate Guitar, which is most of the tabs are pretty good, somebody just transcribes the song wrong. Or they say, well, I've simplified it a lot. Well, that's not a transcription then, so then we have to go and figure it out. Okay.
Now for something completely different.
This is really different. This is
almost 21st century.
This is, this is probably my favorite band from the 90s. I've always wanted to do this song. I think we will at least do it. They are really not an acoustic band, but it'll be interesting.
Yeah, we will not butcher it. Not great, but not butcher it.
It's interesting. It's a good tune, and I love this band. We may do some other songs by them, but I still have to go see if they're still around. All right. Calls me from the cold. Just when I was low, feeling short of stable. All that she intends, and all she keeps inside, isn't on the label. She's ashamed. Can she take me for a while? Can I be a Shimmer by the band Fuel. The song was written by Carl Bell, who was one of the two guys that formed the band. 1998, practically modern, although that's 22 years ago. This is my favorite band from the 90s. They released a couple of albums. I don't think they're still around. I need to go look, but I really liked this band. I thought they had a great sound.
There are two chords for this song. I learned the E minor 9, no 5, and the D sus 2 /A#.
Yeah, this uses a technique which I've actually used in some other songs where you play a C chord on guitar and then you just slide up 2 frets and you get that very distinctive.
And it's like, I don't know how you do this on ukulele. I said, okay, what notes are you playing?
It's called an E minor 9, no 5. Didn't put you at all. Thank you, Rick. Appreciate that. Means a lot coming from you. So I'm talking to Connor, my squire, my lifelong friend. We went to high school together and taught me a lot about when I know how to play guitar. So Connor said it was okay. We're good to go. Really fun song to do, though. If you're looking for some 90s music, check out the band Fuel. Wow, and just like that, a half hour's over. So we have one more song for you. This is a classic among the classics. I'd be willing to bet most of you will know this song. And we had a lot of fun learning this tune. And we've both forgotten about it a little bit. I don't remember how we...
I know this song. I know this artist. I didn't realize... it's like, he's one of these artists that we really should start looking for more of his songs.
We're going to do that. So, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. I feel so bad, I've got a worried mind. I'm so lonesome all the time. Since I left my baby behind on the bayou, saving nickels, saving dimes, work until the sun don't shine, looking forward to happier times. Joe Melson, 1961, although this song has been covered by about a million artists. And we didn't realize it was, when we first started looking at it, we didn't realize it was a Roy Orbison song. And it's from very early in his career, and we did our best to cover his amazing voice. But we are going to be looking at some Roy Orbison music to see if we can find another song by that amazing, amazing performer. I love Roy Orbison, and we're going to do some more of his music for sure. So that is our show for this week, number 32 in the books. Next week, we're going to have my good friend Keith Lewis, one of the other people who spent a lot of time with me teaching me guitar early on. Then we're going to do our Halloween show, and we're going to have Rick Smith back in November. And I think we're going to do another harmonica show with Tom Boland Bob probably sometime in December. schedule is going to be kind of weird through November with Thanksgiving. We're going to do our show that week on Tuesday. We'll make sure we put out the word. Thank you all for joining us. We hope that you are well and safe. We miss everyone terribly. And we'll be doing more music next week. So thank you all so much for joining us. And Rick can let me know if the mic was a success. The sample sounded better. So hopefully we got a good sound. But thank you too, Tracy. Everybody have a great night. And we will see you hopefully next week.
Stay safe.